We married mainstream, thought that it was all a fling. Then the white boy came and it was all a sin. Suddenly rap was backpacking in the cul-de-sacs with skull caps and sullen facts against a rap tab, middle America, but little Erica, the parents gas, Lindsay dropped it low, but really it was all a parent trap. Music hit the scene, ATL lit the fluid, a new black movement, from Young Jocks to Jeezy, Young Jocks of Weezy, after schools and bump the club hits, funny how the outcasts love it, the message of
whoever sees this and subscribes right now, get a free cookie monster. Sesame Street ain't got shit on me. What's going on, YouTube? It's Nox Hill, and we're back with our reaction series. So today, man, it is Thursday, which, as you know, is none other than Mathers Day, which means we are back with more Eminem. Now listen, today's song is a very special one. It's one that sits close to my heart, man, that really has had a huge impact on my life. So I'm excited to share this one with you guys and to dive into this one. It's none other than The Monster with Rihanna. But before we get any further, I want to give a quick shout out to the song in the intro. Listen, if you guys like that, yes, I'm a rapper myself. There's a good chance to like my breakdowns, whether I think about music, you'll probably like my music as well. I have an album, Blacklist, charted on iTunes for the first time. A lot of blood, sweat, tears, and hip-hop put into this one. If you want to support me and support the channel directly, I'll put the links to that below. Also, shout out to the Patreon and Patreon family. Exclusive reactions and content on there. If you guys want to join, again, all links down there. But anyways, we know what we're here for. Eminem, step back up to the plate. Let's see what you got. How have I never seen this music video before? What? What is wrong with me? I'm gonna have to get my stand card back. This is clever. I'm friends with the monster. I love the way that this sets up. You know, you've got Eminem and Rihanna turns on the TV and he's in therapy and she's his therapist. I love that way of featuring her. But as he sits back and he kind of reflects upon his career, and most importantly, he reflects on the character of Shady, isn't it? Who's the man who brought us the violence, the misogyny, the controversy, all of that? It was Shady. And then you look at the different monsters inside of his own head that he has to deal with. Because fame, which this song will discuss, can be a monster in and of itself. You know, and how he deals with and accepts fame. That's a theme throughout this. Addiction as well. The demons in our own heads that lead us to addiction and how we cope and deal with that. And we know Eminem struggles with addiction. He almost killed himself dealing with that. The violence, just everything, how it all ties in. His childhood, his upbringing. And, you know, in a sense, Slim Shady is his monster that he created. And it helps him to cope. And he walks side by side with his monster. And how clever is it the way that it sets up? And I love, you know, you see like the balls that are in a lot of therapy desks that go back, the balls that are in a lot of therapy desks. Wow, that can be, we're not going there today. We're not going there today. But some of the lighting and the way that this sets up, but you hear the ticking of the clock. And it's almost like you start to focus on that. You can kind of go crazy because it's a bit ominous the way that that ticks and the way the balls hit. And you sit there and you're trying to find peace, but really your mind just keeps racing and racing and racing and walking down this path of darkness as Eminem is. So cool. And then this lighting I want to point out. Look at that. Look how that's silhouetted. What a great shot right there. You've got a really strong light behind her, but in the foreground, she's silhouetted. And then Eminem, right there, similar shot as well. And you could see that he's just going through it. He's in his moment of sort of reflection and meditation. But I love the play on the light and the dark. And notice how he's dark. And to me, that's visual symbolism of the darkness within him, the darkness within ourselves, with the light shining upon him.
with the monster, the sound of my bed. Get along with the voices inside of my head.
You try and get it, Riri.
Save me, stop holding your breath. And you think I'm crazy. Yeah, you think I'm crazy.
I wanted the fame, but not the.
Wow. Look at that transition. So we talk about these silhouettes, and then right here, he gets lit up right before he starts rapping. And this hook, man, is so iconic. And shout out to John Bellion, an amazing songwriter, an amazing rapper, amazing producer, singer. What can't that man do? But John Bellion and Baby Rexha wrote this hook. And Bellion said, you know, after they wrote this hook first, they presented it to Eminem. And Bellion gave him this concept. And he said, Eminem just ticked all the boxes, literally what was in my head when we put the pen to the paper and we put together this song. Just the different dimensions of the monster and the way that he addressed it. I mean, he just latched onto that concept and ran away with it.
Me, stop holding your breath. And you think I'm crazy. Yeah, you think I'm crazy.
I wanted the fame, but not the cover of Newsweek. Oh well, guess beggars can't be choosy. Wanted to receive attention from my music. Wanted to be left alone in public, excuse me.
I wanted fame, but not the cover of Newsweek. Oh well. You know, he wanted to make it. He wanted to survive, but he didn't want to be a news headline. He didn't want to be put under the scrutiny because, you know, there's two sides that come to fame, isn't it? We all look at the fame and the glamour of celebrities and we're like, hey, I want that life. You know, it's so cool to go outside and be known. But then it becomes a burden. It can overwhelm sometimes because there's that darker underside to it, isn't it? Where everybody knows you. You never get privacy anymore. And everything that you do is under the public eye and scrutinized. And the way that he comes in, he kind of throws you off because the cover of Newsweek, and you feel like he's going to rhyme right on that and leave that. But then he ends that line with, oh, well. So you're like, oh, is he going to rhyme Newsweek or is he going to rhyme the oh, well? So then you think he's going to rhyme the oh, well. But then he circles back around to rhyming off of the Newsweek. And then he'll go into that two-syllable scheme that he keeps playing off of.
I wanted the fame, but not the cover of Newsweek.
Oh, well.
Guess beggars can't be choosy. Wanted to receive attention from my
music.
Wanted to be left alone in public.
Excuse me.
Wanting my cake and eat it too. And wanting it both ways. Fame made me a balloon. Cause my ego inflated when I flew. See, but it was.
Love this. This is really good cadence control from him. Notice how he comes in. It's a bit lighter. He's kind of like tapping in. Public, excuse me. Newsweek. It's smoother. And then right there, he's just got a quick transition where he gets a little bit more aggressive. You know, he starts really tapping in with the delivery. So he comes softer and then aggressive. And then he brings it back in.
I need it too. And wanting it both ways. Fame made me a balloon. Cause my ego inflated when I.
Cause my ego inflated. See right there how he just taps in with a more aggressive delivery. This is a great example of really using cadence control to help make your verse just incredibly dynamic with your delivery.
Be choosy. Wanted to receive attention from my music. Wanted to be left alone in public. Excuse me. And wanting my cake and eat it too. And wanting it both ways. Fame made me a balloon. Cause my ego inflated when I flew. See, but it was confusing. Cause all I wanted to do is be the Bruce Lee of loosely abused ink.
And right there, he kind of brings the two together. So he starts soft, he gets aggressive, and then those next couple lines, he kind of dabbles between being aggressive to soft, and he goes softer on the Uzi, you know, that those sounding rhymes, loose leaf, excuse me. So every time he goes off of that, but even that last Bruce Lee of loose leaf line, he mixes like kind of aggressive with that softer delivery. It's just really cool how he dives between these different cadence controls. Starts off soft, then the next few lines goes aggressive. And then that set of lines, he like has just a synergy between the two. Just really cool tap in and tap out, man.
Choosy. Wanted to receive attention from my music. Wanted to be left alone in public, excuse me. But wanting my cake and eat it too. And wanting it both ways. Fame made me a balloon. Cause my ego inflated when I flew. See, but it was confusing. Cause all I wanted.
Cause my ego inflated. I love that rhythmic control as well. Da, 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 da. We've seen this a lot. You see it as we go through his songs with Royce the 5'9", especially when he gets a kamikaze, this like tap in, stop very abruptly, and then continue the line sort of flow. Like tap, pause, keep rhyming really fast, tap, pause, and just tap in at different points. It's almost like he's playing a punching bag with a delivery, man.
Ways fame made me a balloon, cause my ego inflated when I flew. See, but it was confusing, cause all I wanted to do is be the Bruce Lee of loosely abused.
I don't know why I had to throw that ad lib in there, but I wanted to be the Bruce Lee of Loose Leaf. You know, he just wanted to kick ass, man. Kick ass and take names. Be at the top of his discipline, of his art, in this case, on Loose Leaf with the pen and paper, man. Just be respected in the game.
It was confusing, because all I wanted to do is be the Bruce Lee of Loose Leaf abused ink. Use it as a tool when I blew steam.
Bruce Lee, Loose Leaf, abused ink when I blew steam. See that condensed? It's a simple two-syllable scheme. But what he's doing is he's getting super punchy right there with it and really condensing that rhyme scheme so it really hits the eardrum.
Be the Bruce Lee of Loose Leaf abused ink. Use it as a tool when I blew steam. Woo! Hit the lottery, ooh wee. But with what I gave it was bittersweet.
Right, abused ink. Get it? Because he's playing off of the martial arts, the Bruce Lee schemes. Like, he's abusing the ink. But then when he hit the lottery, like hitting it, like karate chopping, see the Bruce Lee scheme carrying over, but also like hitting the lottery because he made it. He made it big. This verse is dedicated to the fame, how the fame, you know, swelled like his ego. Everything inflated. Everything blew up. You know, he never really asked for this. He wanted fame to get out of his situation, but now all these downsides to the fame, and he just doesn't feel like he has control of his life anymore. Fame has really become the monster, and this verse really just grabs hold of that symbolism and that metaphor.
Use it as a tool when I blew steam. Woo! Hit the lottery, ooh wee, but with what I gave.
Use it as a tool when I blew steam, and then you hear him go, woo, almost like a Bruce Lee sort of karate chop, like making a noise like that, but also like the steam from a steam train and just making that woo noise.
Used ink. Use it as a tool when I blew steam. Woo! Hit the lottery, ooh wee. But with what I gave up to get, it was bittersweet. It was like winning a used me. I'm running because I think I'm getting so huge I need a shrink. I'm beginning to lose sleep. One sheep.
Love that line right there. And this line, I debated on for a long time. I had no idea what he was saying.
When I blew steam. Woo! Hit the lottery, ooh wee. But with what I gave up to get, it was bittersweet. It was like winning a used me.
I always heard it was like winning a used me, like a bruised and battered me all of a sudden. It's not like a new me that's rich and famous, like, because I've been dragged through the mud and dragged through hell. But actually, it was like winning a used mink, like a mink that you would wear, like mink furs, because that is associated more with something that's higher price, that's richer. So the fame, the rich payments. But if he's getting a used mink, he's not getting something brand new. So even though this is supposed to be nice and shiny, it's used. You know, it has been through it. It has been through the ringer, if we're gonna shout out other Eminem songs.
Hit the lottery, ooh wee, but with what I gave up to get, it was bittersweet. It was like winning a used me. I'm running cause I think I'm getting so huge I need a shrink. I'm beginning to lose sleep. One sheep, two sheep, going cuckoo and kooky is cool key.
Going cuckoo and kooky as cool Keith. I love how he fits Cool Keith into that just two-syllable scheme that he keeps punching this whole verse, man. Shout out to Cool Keith. And you want to talk about split personalities and going kooky. Cool Keith had like just so many different personalities, like 20 different personalities he has used on tracks and throughout his career, man. So I love that shout out right there. And then the irony bars playing off of getting so huge that he needs to shrink. Huge to shrink. We call it a juxtaposition. Don't we, when you take, you know, two sort of contradictory terms, two opposites, and you put them together in a verse. So playing off of a shrink, because he might need a shrink to just help to deflate all the fame and all the ego and all the shit that he's dealing with. But also a shrink, a doctor, to help him just cope with all the issues and everything that comes from it.
What I gave up to get, it was bittersweet. It was like winning a used me. I'm running because I think I'm getting so huge I need a shrink. I'm beginning to lose sleep. One sheep, two sheep, going cuckoo and kooky is cool.
And that lose sleep line goes a little bit deeper for me, because we know that Eminem and sleep pills is what really he got hooked on and really addicted to, because he couldn't sleep. And that really kind of led to sort of his physical demise dealing with that. And what do you do when you're trying to fall asleep? You're counting sheep. But also it could be like you're going crazy in your head, like you're literally counting sheep and hallucinating and seeing things.
Getting so huge I need a shrink. I'm beginning to lose sleep. One sheep, two sheep, going cuckoo and kooky is cool key. But I'm actually weirder than you think, cause I'm
friends with the mom.
And we didn't even get a chance to talk about the visuals because so much is happening with the lyricism. But Dr. Dre, then being his doctor again, he likes to play the role of being his doctor. And Eminem in the straight jacket, like we've seen Eminem in the past rocking the straight jacket. So a little bit of homage being paid to the old days, which reflects when he looks into the TV, doesn't it? Because the TV's paying homage to the old days. We saw him in Kim. We saw him in Haley. We saw him on 8 Mile Road, rapping Lose Yourself. You know, you saw different iconic M songs, him falling, jumping off of the building, right? So you see all of those in The Way I Am. And then you see that sort of reflection now with him delivering in the present tense similar themes and similar stories.
Get along with the voices inside of my head.
This is such a good hook. So how we started, you know, "Hi, my name is" when he's going crazy, right, with the straitjacket. Now, here we are, reflecting 8 Mile and Lose Yourself, the album cover, the same scene that he rapped on Lose Yourself. I love as the elevator goes down, we go through the different sort of career arc and life story of Eminem. That's so clever. And a little bit more on this hook, man. I just think this whole concept is great because, one, it's a great way to talk about one's inner demons. And to me, that's a story and a struggle that's so relatable to anyone. You know, and the way that this is flipped is, you know, because Eminem has that crazy side, doesn't he? And are we going crazy? And, you know, there's a fine line between genius and madness, isn't there? And I'm sure Eminem feels like he walks sort of a tightrope act between those two. So you play off of those demons because when you hear voices in your head, you could be considered crazy, especially if you start responding to those voices and talking to those voices. I mean, we all go through inner dialogues, don't we? But there's sort of a fine line between that. So there's like this literal craziness of the monsters that you hear and the demons inside of your head, but also more of the metaphorical, because we all have demons. You know, we all have issues. We all have dark sides. We're all human beings. With the light comes dark. We all have flaws and things in our past that we're not proud of. You know, that we have to learn how to cope with and live with and deal with. And that's kind of the only way forward. And that's sort of the theme of this whole song is how do you cope with those monsters? And, you know, in the end of this, it's about living and accepting those monsters. And then you relate it also to childhood. And we all can relate as kids being afraid of, you know, the monster underneath of our beds. But in reality, you know, it's those monsters and it's us finding a way to embrace our past that can lead us into our future. And we can learn from it and it can make us stronger. Oh man, perfect timing. I forgot about that. You know, you better lose yourself in the music, the moment. You know, you only get one shot. You got to seize this moment. So somebody told me to seize this moment. I'm not much a poet. Actually, he is a poet, man. He is a rap poet. But I love how we're equating that intro to Lose Yourself with the lines of this verse in this track right here. And he's also done it on Sing for the Moment as well, talking about squeezing hold of the moment and not letting it go. Hang on one second. I think I lost my screen recording software. Sorry, guys. I had to check that, but we're back. And also you hear on this part, right, that there's like this demonic voice. And that sounds like the monster, like him aligning with this monster for a moment. And this monster and that demon in our heads is talking underneath. There's M rapping out in front of the mix. And then there's also sort of that demon within the mix underneath of it all. All could be over tomorrow, so I keep conjuring. Sometimes and don't squander it, cause you never know when it all could be over tomorrow, so I keep conjuring. Sometimes I wonder what these thoughts. And you hear how he comes out of that? So I keep conjuring. Get it, conjuring, like conjuring this wizardry that Eminem cooks up like he's Harry fucking Potter, Lord Voldemort, but also flipping on that, like conjuring up demons. And you can hear the demon within his voice right there. There's sort of a double entendre with the production itself that's really clever. Cause you never know when it all could be over tomorrow, so I keep conjuring. Sometimes I wonder where these thoughts spawn from. Yeah, conjure it, do you want to know? Sometimes I wonder where these thoughts spawn from. Get it? Like demons spawn, but where do they rise? Where do they come from? But he used the word spawn to tie in with that conjuring scheme, and he's very good at the word choice that he has sometimes to align sort of trains of thought, and he wants to stay on that demonic scheme because then he sets it up where he goes in and starts rapping in this demonic voice, and that's the monster literally talking back to him now. So I keep conjuring. Sometimes I wonder where these thoughts spawn from. Yeah, conjure it, do you want? There's no one. If you're losing your mind the way it wants. I think you've been wandering off down yonder and stumbled on to Jeff Van Conjuring. Think you were wandering, and he plays off of wandering in multiple ways right here. This is very, very clever how he plays on this scheme. Sometimes I wonder where these thoughts spawn from. So he plays on wonder there, and then he goes in, you know, pondering. It can do wonders, like wonders for you, but it could also drive you crazy. See the different ways that he plays on wondering. So in one sense, like he's wondering, he's thinking, and he's playing off of pondering. But then also, like, wonders and miracles and things that it can do and create. And then there's also a play on that in a slant rhyme in a bend as he then goes off of wonder into sort of wondering, wandering, because there was also wondering, like wondering if he would make it, if he would get famous and be up there. And then he goes yo to Leihihu because he wants to show that his mind is really just all over the place and all over the box, like me trying to explain the complexity of that scheme and all the different word flips and meanings that he had. And it's like, yeah, this man is just a creative, crazy genius in one sense.
No, I ain't much of a poet, but I know somebody once told me to seize the moment and don't squander it. Cause you never know when it all could be over tomorrow, so I keep conjuring.
Sometimes I wonder where these thoughts spawn from.
Yeah, ponder it, do you wonder? No wonder if you're losing your mind the way it wanders.
I think you've been wandering off down yonder and stumbled on to Jeff Van Dondren. Cause I need an intervention.
Jeff Van Dondren, who was also on Intervention, who does like different talks on, you know, taking care of yourself, overcoming addiction and habits. And there's no coincidence there that he puts that into those lyrics, because we know that he really needed an intervention because he struggled seriously with addiction and it almost took his life from him.
Wandering off down yonder and stumbled on to Jeff Van Dondren, cause I need an interventionist to intervene between me and his monster.
Oh, now we're paying homage to The Way I Am as he's falling down. That's so good.
Save me from myself and all this conflict, cause of everything that I love.
To save me from myself and all of this conflict. See again, da 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 da, pause, tap, back out. See that pause and tap in sort of scheme where he gets super breathy? Again, I just love that just rhythm switch up that he does.
In between me and this monster, and save me from myself and all this conflict, cause of everything that I love killing me and I can't conquer it. My OCD's talking me in the head, keep knocking, nobody's home, I'm sleepwalking. I'm just relaying what the voice in my head saying, don't shoot the messenger, I'm just friends with them.
My OCD, his perfectionism, you know, overthinking can lead to paralysis sometimes. I mean, if you live inside of your own head, you can really drive yourself crazy if you think too much. And I definitely relate to those lines a lot. And, you know, Eminem playing off of, again, the sleepwalking scheme. Like people sleeping on him, but he's sleepwalking because it feels like he's going crazy. Is he dreaming? Is this real? He doesn't really know. And again, don't forget the addiction to the sleeping pills.
Talking, I'm just relaying what the voice in my head saying. Don't shoot the messenger. I'm just relaying what the voice in my head saying.
It's almost like, don't blame me, you know, just blame Shady in this case. Don't shoot the messenger in this case. I'm just telling you what this other voice and this demonic thing is going on. And it's almost like, you know, it's a way for him to kind of come to terms with that. So we have the first verse, which is dealing with fame and that monster. And the second verse for me is more of now Eminem personally dealing with past regrets, dealing with doubts, dealing with, you know, that monster inside of him. One is an external monster. This one is more of the internal monster. Now, how does he deal with all of his monsters? And one of those is also addiction and touching upon that. And see just the different ways that he approaches it and attacks just the themes of this track.
My love's killing me and I can't conquer it. My OCD's talking me in the head. Keep knocking. Nobody's home. I'm sleep.
And my OCD's conquering me. And right there, the beat kind of skips. It's like, it just gets super punchy on that beat. And someone like Eminem, who really loves his rhythms, like that's breaking apart the smooth rhythm of the beat. That's gonna mess with his OCD.
Can't conquer it. My OCD's talking me in the head. Keep knocking. Nobody's home. I'm sleepwalking. I'm just relaying what the voice in my head said.
And then, you know, is anybody home behind the doors, right? You knock on the doors. Is anybody home up here in your brain upstairs? What's going on? So much clever wordplay just tying in with this sort of psychology monster scheme that we have.
Knocking me in the head, keep knocking, nobody's home. I'm sleepwalking, I'm just relaying what the voice in my head saying. Don't shoot the messenger, I'm just
friends with the monster, the son of my bed. Get along with the voices inside of my head.
Rihanna can do whatever she wants, man. I love just the rockiness of this. Girl's a fucking rock star, a pop star, R&B icon. Girl can do what she wants.
You're trying to save me, stop holding your breath. And you think I'm crazy.
I mean, you talk about the power of music and why it's an outlet. And when this song came out, and I heard it on the radio, it got me through some tough shit, man. You know, I mean, that's the power of music. And, you know, I've had plenty of demons that I've had to deal with, and, you know, depression and anxiety and mistakes and regrets and getting too caught up in my own head and just paralyzing myself. And this song kind of helped me to just go, you know what, I'm not alone. You know, I'm not the only one dealing with this and going through this. And there were times when I was like, man, am I crazy? Like, I don't even know how to fit in with society sometimes. I just feel so out of place and I have so many conflicting voices in my own head. And sometimes you even talk to those voices and I can't speak enough on the power of music. And it's even hard for me now to kind of reach back into those times because it's like we're away from that now. And that's opening up old scars and wounds. But in a sense, the theme of the song is being able to open up those scars and to walk hand in hand and accept yourself and kind of who you are. And just, man, it's such a powerful one. I'm nervous too because I just want to do this song justice as well. This song really means a lot.
Call me crazy, but I had this vision. One day that I'll walk amongst you, a regular civilian. But until then, chance to kill.
Call me crazy, but also like literally, he can be crazy because of all the voices in his head. And if you're crazy, you're not going to be allowed to walk amongst people. But then that's a very clever double because he's playing off of this saying, like, call me crazy. Like, he's not seriously crazy, but call him crazy. Because it's crazy to think that he could walk amongst us and just be regular because of how famous he is, how big he is now. He can't walk out in public anymore and not be recognized because he's Eminem. I mean, that's the dark side to it.
I had this vision, one day that I'll walk amongst you, a regular civilian. But until then, drums get killed and I'm coming straight at MC's blood gets spilled.
Right, what's really clever here, civilian, spilled then. So he plays off of that. So he's got, let's call those the B schemes. And then day that, playback, A at. So he's got the A schemes. And he's going to jump between these A and Bs, A and Bs. And he might go BB, A. A, B, B. Just really clever writing. When he does the, like, playback, way that, he, like, punches up in the cadence. And then civilian. He stays lower on the cadence for the B rhyme. So great use, again, of the delivery and the cadence to highlight the differences in the rhyme schemes and what he's doing here.
Call me crazy, but I had this vision. One day that I'll walk amongst you, a regular civilian. But until then, drums get killed, and I'm coming straight at MC's blood.
Right, civilian, killed then. Straight at, right? Blood gets spilled then. He's gonna keep doing this. Just very clever how he's running this.
Spilled then I'll take it back to the days that I get on a Dre track. Give every kid who got played that bump the feeling and shit to say back.
Right, and then he goes, so he went like B, B to A. And then right there he goes A, A, A. And then he goes back to B very quickly with the rhyme writing. Very clever, man.
But until then, drums get killed, and I'm coming straight at MC's blood gets spilled, and I'm taking back to the days that I get on a Dre track. Give every kid who got played that bump the feeling and shit to say back.
See, bump the feeling, shit to say that, illin, A that. Again, it's so clever. And take him back to the days of Dre when he was like Mr. Not Give a Fuck, Mr. Shady, just setting the world on fire, man. I mean, this is what I feel those days, man. Those rebellious days of Eminem.
To the days that I get on a Dre track. Give every kid who got played that bump the feeling and shit to say back. To the kids who played them, I ain't here to save the fucking children. But if one kid out of 100 million who are going through a struggle feels it and relates, that's great. It's payback.
I mean, that's it, man. He's not here to save the children. I mean, he makes eye-opening music. He makes controversial music. You know, he has songs like Kim, where he talks about killing Kim. And he goes crazy off the deep end, but music is his outlet. And he's kind of like the anti-hero, isn't he? Like, he just accepts that he's a villain and he's a menace. But you can't help but root for him because then he makes songs like this. And then he makes songs where he just shows us his vulnerability. And he shows us what's going on in his head and in his world. And he does actually want to inspire people. And he kind of wants to set an example. He's not a role model, but at the same time, he wants to make meaningful music that can help people. And that can inspire people. And if it does, that's fucking great in his world. And that's amazing. So you know what I'm saying? Like, he's not setting out to be like Mr. Perfect and Mr. Kids Follow Me. Because he doesn't, he said it many times. He's not a role model. He's not meant to be followed. But he still makes music that is meaningful. Music with substance. And music that has touched so many lives throughout the years. And that's just kind of the essence of Eminem and who he is.
Out of 100 million who are going.
There's him hugging Elton. Oh, and then they're repeating it in real life when he hugs Elton John. That's right.
Feel.
You know, when everyone said Eminem doesn't like gay people. Well, guess what? Then he performs with Elton John and plays Stan.
And relates, that's great. It's payback. Russell Wilson falling way back in the trap. Turn nothing into something, still connected.
Ah.
one kid out of 100 million who are going through a struggle feels it and relates. That's great. It's payback. Russell Wilson falling way back in the.
It's payback. Russell Wilson falling way back. Oh man, camera died. Sorry guys, we're back. The Russell Wilson lines I really like because, you know, Russell Wilson, he fell way back to third round in the draft. You know, people said he was too short. You know, he couldn't see the pocket fully. He wasn't going to mount anything. Never mind those intangibles that he was a winner, that he was a great leader. He had a high football IQ. And I mean, obviously, look how great of a quarterback he is still to this day. Go Broncos now. But, you know, he helped the Seahawks win a Super Bowl. And it's kind of like Eminem. If you look at Eminem, when he dropped Infinite in those days, like, it's like, yeah, this man's got some talent, but nah, he's never going to be great. He's never really going to make it. You know, he's a guest of hip hop. He's a white boy. I mean, this is hip hop. Essentially, this is black music, isn't it? But Eminem has come through and he's just shattered expectations and he's still here and he's still doing
kids
it.
Who played him, I ain't hit his.
And then even Russell Wilson. See that illin? Civilian Russell Wilson. He's still got those B schemes. Play that's great. Way back. And he's still got those A schemes. So this whole verse, he's staying on cue with these A and B rhymes. It's amazing.
Every kid who got played that, pumped the villain and shit to say back. To the kids who played them, I ain't here to save the fucking children. But if one kid out of 100 million who are going through a struggle feels it and relates, that's great. It's payback. Russell Wilson falling way back in the draft. Turn nothing into something, still can make.
Payback. Falling way back. Got some Tupac right there. Payback. I knew you bitches from way back. Know I stay strapped with gas. Know I don't play that. Shout out to that song. If you know what I'm talking about, comment down below. Rest in peace to Pac.
If one kid out of 100 million who are going through a struggle feels it and relates, that's great. It's payback. Russell Wilson falling way back in the draft. Turn nothing into something, still can make that. Straw in the gold, jump I will spin. Rumpelstiltskin in a haystack.
Ah, jump I will spin. Rumpelstiltskin in a haystack. And he still stays on that AAC scheme, man. So good. And then he just switches up and has another crazy condensed rhyme scheme. But Rumpelstiltskin, you know, in the story of Rumpelstiltskin being able to turn straw into gold. Eminem's story, taking shit or rising above it, coming from nothing in poverty and somehow turning it into gold. And look at his success now.
Something still can make that straw into gold. Jump, I will spin. Rumpelstiltskin in a haystack. Maybe I need a straight jacket, face facts. I am nuts for real, but I'm okay with that. It's nothing, I'm still friends with the
Maybe I am crazy. Maybe I need to be put in a straight jacket, but I'm okay with that. And for me, that's the big culmination and resolution right there. I'm friends with that monster. You know, I've been through all this now, and I've learned to accept my past and accept my flaws and accept my own monsters and deal with it. I notice right here how before we had more of the electric guitars and the rocky vibe, and this gets more acoustic, right? And you start strumming the acoustic guitar, and everything kind of drops out here. Just a cool little, just different way to approach a hook, where before Reed was just going all power chords and going just way out and pushing it. And right here, this kind of brings you in. It's more of a moment of breathing and kind of heartfelt.
My head, you're trying to save me. Stop holding your breath. And you think I'm crazy.
You hear there? There's like a ooh, there's like a ghost in the mix. Like get along with. You can hear it's like Eminem's trying to break out of the mix. The way that that's been frequented, it sounds almost like a ghost, but it's Eminem's voice, and it's just really been messed with right here.
Get along with coming in. Voices inside of my head. You're trying.
Ah, that's so cool. It just hits like one side, then the other side, then the other side, in between Rihanna singing, man. And right here, what a moment when he's just running into his old self. That's shady. That's shady locked in the cage, isn't it?
Save me, stop holding your breath. You think I'm crazy. Yeah, you think I'm crazy. Well, that's not fair. Well, that's not fair.
Wow. It's haunting, man. I mean, I think it's a great example of how you can just make a hit song that's catchy, that people are going to sing along to, but also something that's deeper, that has substance. And I always say what's really hard is to combine sort of that substance and that consciousness with entertainment and with songs that get people moving and songs that get the head nodding. And if you could find a medium between the two, like I feel like this song does, then you've really won the game at the end of the day. Man, I hope I did that one justice, honestly, because that's, of all the M songs, it's probably one of the most important ones to me personally. When I'm gone, you saw how I struggled through that one. But yeah, hopefully I did all right on that and, you know, you guys enjoyed it. But this goes without saying, Eminem, you were Knoxville certified. So if you guys liked today's video, as always, be sure to smash the like button. Listen, if you're here at the end, obviously enjoying the content, do me a favor, subscribe, notifications on, support the channel directly. As always, just a reminder, stay safe, stay positive. It's Knoxville. I'll catch you again. I'm out.